The subject sat nervously in his chair. To me, he was only known as D0983, a man in his early 20s, bald from the chemotherapy he'd undergone during the past year. His health insurance wasn't going to cover any further treatment, which is how he initially got into contact with the Foundation. He was a terminal case, too sick for the Foundation to cure, but he didn't need to know that. I put a closed envelope in front of him. Inside lay a picture of SCP-096, a creature no living person had ever seen. That picture was one of the few recordings of SCP-096's appearance, more specifically, its face. We were trying to determine the creature's triggers. Based on prior documented encounters, it would respond aggressively to anyone observing its face. Whether or not that pertained to pictures and videos as well remained to be seen. "What's inside?" the man asked nervously. We were sitting inside a large, three-story office building with a basement. SCP-096 had been transported from its holding cell for the experiment. All personnel had been removed for the occasion, causing an eerie atmosphere keenly felt by the subject. "A picture. I'd like you to open it and have a look," I said sternly.
"That's all? Why?"
"That's on a need-to-know basis. As our subject, you are not cleared to know anything more than exactly what I tell you." He looked at me with a hint of anger showing through his scared facade.
"My name is Jonathan. I'm not just a subject."
Truth be told, I didn't want to know his name. The fake guise of anonymity helped ease the guilt I felt when putting our subject into life-threatening situations. But once he'd told me, I couldn't view him as a nameless object. "And yet, you are not clear to know what we intend with this experiment. You are, however, within your rights to terminate this meeting, but that will void the contract." His expression turned to one of concern.
"No, wait. I'll do it," he responded meekly.
He held the envelope in his hands, carefully caressing it as if he was handling an explosive. Logically, he knew there was nothing more than a picture inside, something that on its own could never harm him. Yet he knew enough about the Foundation to understand that things were never that simple. Though his knowledge contained little more than rumors and glimpses of our most open facilities, he was clearly worried.
"Is it dangerous?" he asked.
"I'm not sure," I answered as honestly as I could. Truth be told, at that point in time, we had very little information about SCP-096. Based on the documented encounters, not a single person had seen the creature's face and lived. Personally, I'd only seen a vague outline of its back as it was transported on site. It seemed docile, though absolutely menacing in nature, standing more than 2 meters tall with unnaturally long arms. Despite its almost non-existent muscle mass, it could tear a man apart without breaking a sweat. But it had never been the most terrifying part of the creature's mythos. What truly put the fear of God in our men was the blood-curdling scream it let out as it went into a furious rage. I'd only heard recordings, of course. Even as a Class C interviewer, I'd never been put in that situation. The screams never sounded purely angry, but rather agonizing. It was akin to someone losing a loved one, but distorted, broken into fragments, and put back together in the wrong order. It was a mixture of fear, sadness, and anger all at once. "Are you ready?" I asked. Jonathan nodded, still staring at the unopened envelope. He'd been well briefed on the plan, and by the Foundation's measures, he was fully secured. The office building we found ourselves within had been separated into 5 levels of security, with several thick blast doors separating the subject from SCP-096. Our goal was to find out not only its triggers, but its strength. "Don't open the envelope until we've cleared the area. We'll keep an eye on you through the cameras and keep contact through radio. We'll notify you as soon as we're ready." The cameras had been specifically designed to not record SCP-096's face, and AI had been developed to automatically edit it out so as to not put any of our personnel into harm's way. That way, we could keep an eye on the subject while not risking our own safety. I left him alone in the most secure room of the office building. The guards were all escorted off property, but were ready to move in should the creature leave the office perimeters, though we fully expected it to return to its docile state immediately after ending the experiment. We sat in an armored truck with dozens of monitors. I was nervous in anticipation of finally witnessing SCP-096 in full view, except for the face, of course. the creature had been placed within a heavy metal container in the basement, one that something of its size should not possibly be able to escape. That being said, SCP-096 was not a creature confined to the laws of natural physics. Our subject sat in his chair, looking around the room as if waiting for something. In his hand, he still held the envelope. I picked the radio up and contacted him. "We're ready. Open the envelope." With noticeable trepidation, the subject tore the paper open, taking out a picture. No sooner had he laid his eyes upon it than his face lit up with terror.
What is this thing?" he asked.
"Please describe what you see," I demanded.
It's a still frame taken from a video or something. It's just a face in darkness, but it's..."
He trailed off. "It's what?" I asked him to clarify.
"It can't be human. Its eyes are completely white and its jaws are unhinged. What the hell is this thing?"
Before we could respond to his question, another sound overwhelmed our communication systems. SCP-096 had left its dormant state and was starting to scream. A strange, static-like voice penetrated the radio silence from the basement, riling up from mere noise to a blood-curdling scream.
"What's that sound?"
the subject asked over the radio, barely audible over the screaming. A loud, metallic bang could be heard as SCP-096 broke through its container with ease. On the cameras, we could see the massive outline rush up from the basement. As it entered the first of five security points, it just tore through the metal as if it was nothing. "Stay in place," I ordered, as the subject kept getting more and more restless.
"No, fuck this. I don't know what that thing is, but I'm not staying here," he yelled back over the radio.
All the while, SCP-096 kept getting closer and closer, tearing through each and every checkpoint with ease. He wouldn't stop until the subject was dead, and if we tried to stop him before that, we'd just lose more men. The subject got out from his chair and started looking for a way out, but every exit had been sealed to keep him away from the creature. As we'd already observed, it wouldn't hold long. He was essentially trapped inside a metal cage, soon to be torn apart by the rapidly approaching creature. Within 10 minutes of the initial viewing, SCP-096 had gotten to the last set of security doors separating it from the subject.
"Please, help me,"
he screamed, not knowing that I had ordered all my men to stand down. The creature started tearing at the doors, all the while screaming relentlessly. With a single hit, it tore a chunk of metal away from the door, throwing it away with its long, lanky arm. Without pausing, it slammed its other hand onto the door, producing loud bends at the site of impact. Little by little, it ripped metal away, finally creating a hole through the door.
"Oh God, what the hell is that thing?"
he called out. But the rest of us were too shocked from the sight to even respond. From there, the monstrosity didn't hesitate to strike. It rushed over to the subject, grabbed onto him as he tried to flee, and ripped his arm straight out of its socket. Jonathan let out a yelp of agony, but he wouldn't even get a chance to breathe before SCP-096 picked him with both arms and tore him in half. I was almost happy it went by that fast. At least he wouldn't have to suffer. The life fled from his body with an almost inaudible gasp, and he fell limp as the two parts of his body landed on the ground. With that, the screaming slowly faded, and SCP-096 just walked silently around the room as he let out loud sobs. We had finally confirmed that pictures would trigger the beast, which meant we could effectively contain the creature from there on out.
"All right, send them in. Contain the creature," I said as I turned the cameras off.
Then we turned the power in the building off, plunging it into darkness as a containment team was sent in with infrared goggles. That way they could track SCP-096 without actually looking at its face. It didn't take long as it had already returned to its docile state. A bag was put over his head, and it was led back to the transport vehicle. The mission was over, and the picture, alongside the footage, was destroyed. Item number, SCP-096. Object class, Euclid.